Management went when they told me to remind everybody out there that there is no eating out in this venue. Inside joke, I guess. All right, folks. You and I, we're all Americans here. We've all had the joy of being through the public education system. You love school. Start up the pit because it's gonna happen. Public education, number one. Public sports, number two. What we might call two great tastes that go terrible together. I can't hear your fingers, sir, but you can hear this. And it starts with our musical question. Ray? How about, very perceptive. Hey, Ray, how about them?
Let you go.
Folks, I've been around this, folks, I've been around this great grand world of ours. Now let me tell you, I've met people of every stripe, color, nationality, and creed. But nonetheless, everybody seems to laugh in the face of tragedy. And you folks are no exception. Because while we were having our technical difficulties up here, or our not so near technical difficulties, while I was waiting to try to figure out when I gotta get that hearing aid, because people are always trying to talk to me about Jennifer Lopez, but it still does not make any sense. So while I'm there thinking about Jennifer Lopez, and guitar tech, and bass playing.
We're playing that later,
I
by the way.
I can't do myself.
Jennifer Lopez.
You're getting the extended mix segue, folks, so just consider yourselves lucky. I wasn't the one who paid money for the show. So, I don't know where the better intelligence ended up. Alright, folks. This is the difference between a microphone and a not microphone. It goes something. Goes something like, oh, this guy's gonna blow an artery or something. Jesus Christ.
Get back to the subject, Chris.
Anyway, while I was contemplating my navel and thinking about all you wonderful people out there, it struck me that, look, I don't need any more of this Jennifer Lopez bullshit. It gets older for me than it does before for you. All right. And without further ado, folks, I will tell you that while you were all yelling to high heaven, the star quarterback lies injured on Rodgers on the football field. Looks like his neck's been broken. Seems to happen somewhere every year. His mom and dad, they clutch themselves and they cry. Their favorite son will never walk again. Coach says that boy gave 100%. What spirit, what a man. But who
once more, now that we have a new show.
obviously worried and concerned. I do not think that you are leveraging your branding across all available social network platforms. And I think the only solution for this is for everybody in a band out there to put your music out for free. Absolutely. Not only that, I want you to bring down your door prices. Somehow, in between all of that, you will make money. I guarantee it.
Oh,
I have a new song. It's called Technical Difficulties. It goes like this. Technical difficulties. We're on stage. What about the center mic? Let's put some tape on the center mic. Let's put some tape over my mouth while I give you this great new song called Technical Difficulties. Technical Difficulties. I have technical difficulties in my thoughts.
Everybody pray for Ray's guitar.
Thank you. Folks, stop, stop, just stop. Hold on. Folks, you may be familiar, we're on like a 365 day tour. This is day 150. And, you know, I hate to do this here, folks. Some of you may be happy with this news, but I can't do this anymore. I can't. My heart's racing, and I can hardly hear. You know, actually, when I think about it, I think I know why. I have become too old for punk rock, folks. Not only that, however, and I'm sure you didn't see this coming, you have become too old for punk rock. As if there weren't enough haters out there, I'm telling you right now, punk rock is over. It's been over for 20 years. And I'm telling you, the only punk anybody here should be listening to is Daft Punk. I'm serious. You probably think I'm joking. But folks, we like to help our fans. Playing the good music and playing for you now the new wave music. We'll be right back. folks, there's nothing I like better at punk rock shows than sad attempts at witty banter. Yeah, I figured you did too. So folks, we're gonna have that awkward moment, but not so awkward, where you are going to learn more than you want to know about the people on this stage. Folks, if you want to get with me, there's some things you need to know. I like my beats fast and my bass down low. And folks, the bass doesn't get any lower than the man to my right. You want to yell at something, please raise your voices to Mr. Klaus Fluoride. Now, folks, when you're walking down that street and you're starting to feel the heat of that rock steady beat, well, mister, you better start to move your feet to the rock steady beat. I already used beat, but from Mr. D.H. Pellegro. Oh yeah. Folks, I think we have witnessed it on the stage that the man from Mars no longer eats cars or goes to bars. Now he only seems to be eating this man's guitars. Folks, I don't believe in spiritual healing, but will you please all concentrate that the guitar of this man will make it through the next few songs. So chant with me in a weird occult sense, East Bay Ray!
You know what? When I was young, I was a twister. And now, I only bow and I only twist my hips to Skip McSkipster. All right, singer, Skip McSkipster, let's hear it.
Let's send this rocket to the moon. Crash. Folks, you know already, I think I have demonstrated that I fucking hate witty banter. I will never succumb to witty banter. But this man up here talks pure science. So I ask that you please all shut your fucking mouths and give it up again for Mr. D.H. Pellegro.
All right, Canyon Club. Is it Canyon Club or Country Club? Canyon. You know what, man? You know what? Michael Brown's fucking dead. Trayvon Martin's dead. Martin Luther King fucking dead. You know, and all these people are dead, and they're not coming back because they just looked a little different and thought a little different, man. You know? What would our fucking world be if everybody thought the same and looked the same and acted like fucking robots? You know what? And you know what? And racism isn't a thing that you were born with. It's some shit that's taught to you throughout your life. If you're dumb and gullible enough to believe it, then you just join the fucking crowd, man. You know what? I believe that us punk rockers have the ability to fucking change. We make the change. We need to be that change that we want to see. And not sit back on our laurels and let the fucking world be run for us, man. You know what? And you know, I want to live. I don't want to just be fucking shot randomly walking down the street for no reason at all. And I wouldn't want anything to happen to any of you guys. So treat people like you want to be treated, man. That's all there is to it. And all those people who are preaching the hate and all that bullshit, those Nazi fucking rednecks can fuck off. Nazi punks. Nazi punks! One more time, Nazi punks!
Everybody wants the same company as the same company.
to get political. How's that working out for you? In the name of world peace, in the name of world promise, I will go out and take my place. America needs fuel to get it and big puppets. What the hell is dead if it's keeping out filling the blank? Is a crazy, crazy place, but never let it be forgotten that satire is able to change the world if applied correctly. You could do it in a newspaper. You could do it on television news. You could do it on your poli-sci blog. To know, sir, is that the most important words that have ever been said come from the mouth of a punk rock singer. When Ronald Reagan comes to town and pops a tongue at human rights,
we'll be right back.
teach you something like an itch. You won't ever wanna act like you. Just ask for your bed so you can get rich. When you're watching the universe about you.
Clouds. Go it down, down, down.
until. Thank you very much. Good night. 1, 2, 3, 4.